Well, this is how many of you started your day today. We found neighbors digging out on Cranmere Lane in Springsbury Township in York County. Many of us dread cleaning up after a storm. Snow removal is hard work that can require some heavy lifting. And shoveling the wrong way could land you in the ER. Dr. Tim Kauffman has been a physical therapist for nearly 40 years. And over that time, he's helped a lot of people with injuries caused by snow shoveling. So tonight, we asked him to show us the safest way to move snow.
First of all, before shoveling, you should warm up just a little bit. Stretch, move around. The important thing is that you don't go out into the cold without warming up your body. It's always easier to push, but you can see this snow, you can't push very far. So if you pick it up, I'm bending my knees, I'm keeping my back mostly straight, and I'm trying to push it forward, as opposed to the incorrect technique is to do this. That's very, very, very bad for your back. So when I'm throwing something, I try to keep my arms close to my body. I don't throw too far. And again, I do not twist. Okay, that's wrong. I do not twist. If I'm going to throw it that way, I've got to throw it and step with it. It's important if your gloves get wet, replace them, because frostbite in the hands is a very important issue. You may want to remove your hat. It's estimated that 25% of your body heat can be lost through your head. So if you're overheated, unzip your jacket, take your hat off, but it's important that you don't sweat profusely. And another important side of that is continue to hydrate whenever you are shoveling.
That all sounds familiar. The American Physical Therapy Association has some tips to help you avoid snow shoveling injuries. We have a link to it on our website, WGAL.com.